this program that we are doing today is a Global Students Ideas Exchange Program. So, as you guys know, we have on one side a team from Mount Abu Public School, New Delhi, India. And on the other hand, we have the students of Campin School, Kathmandu, Nepal. So, the topic of discussions for today will be food.
So, like in India, different states have different foods.
Exactly.
And is there like this in Nepal also?
Yeah.
So, the thing is, Nepal, like it was not a country before, right? So all the states that we have right now in Nepal, they were like countries. And Prithvi Narayan Shah, the king of Shah dynasty, he united our country. So yeah, we have cultures different. And it's diverse.
Different ethnic groups. The best part is every ethnic group love to try different foods of different ethnic groups. And there is unity in diversity in our country. And that is the best part of our country.
That's the strength, we can say.
Yes.
Yes. Even we can say that for our country. Because we can see a huge diversity in our country. Every state you can find different religion, different type of languages and all. Still we are united, and I'm really proud that India has managed to be integrated till now
and this country. So much diversity, every culture and every
despite of all that,
we managed to bring them together.
But like despite of the diversity, why do you think India is a Hindu country? It's as a Hindu country, right?
Not exactly, it is not considered. Our constitution guarantees all preamble of our constitution, secularism is clearly mentioned, and our constitution is right to convert into any religion and prosper any religion he or she might want to.
Practice any
religion. Hinduism is in majority, but every religion.
That's great.
We have reservations in every sector, so as to put up the minorities like Muslims and.
We share so much in common, like both of our countries, we have so much in common.
That's because we were united once, right?
Parts of our countries.
So, what is the street food in Nepal?
Street food in Nepal.
Street food.
Do you guys know
Japanese?
In Delhi, people are mad about pani puri.
Same here. What do you call pani puri in Delhi?
We call it puchka. Basically, more of vegetables like onions and all are put in puchka. But in Delhi, we have potatoes and only boiled potatoes and chicken are added along with sweet water. And we want it spicy, as spicy as Italians
love spicy.
Same year. Everybody is crazy about pani puri.
So that famous food in Delhi, what do you find more?
You can find variety of food in our country, like in our state basically.
Diversity from everywhere, like from every part of India, we have food in Delhi.
So if we consider Delhi as the only part of India, then we can see chole bhature as the very famous food.
Yeah, we had that in school.
Although it is heavy, but still it is taken as breakfast.
Paranthas are also taken.
Paranthas.
In Delhi, there is a market called Chandni Chowk where there is parantha. So
our street is named as Paranthawala Gali. Paranthas are only made there. So like Maharaja of Kashmir and our old president, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, they have visited that particular shop to eat parathas.
So that's like the most famous dish there. Yeah.
You may consider it. Means everyone enjoys it. Like exactly. If you want to have a snack, you want to have it as a main course, you can have it like any way.
Oh, that's great. So glad to try that someday. Yeah. So if like by chance if any one of us visits India, is there something that we should definitely try? Because that's what India is all about or something?
Like you can have everything. Yeah. Like when you can have your dal bati, you can have a burger, pizza.
Everything is available in India. Is there any kind of like culture food? Because if you come in Nepal, we have this samai bhaji, and that's like culture food of Nepal, and you should definitely try it. It's like
it's like the main.
Is there any culture food in India like that?
Like we already said, the culture every state. Yeah.
Sorry.
And the state changes, the cultural food changes. So in Kolkata particularly, they are very famous.
And in South India, there are idli, dosa.
So you don't have like a main thing, right?
No, we have a lot.
I would love to. I would love to try everything and eat everything.
Everything is important to us, basically.
Food is.
We need proper balance.
So yeah, the first thing would be
asking. One thing you can drink after coming to India is chai.
Chai. Morning tea. Ginger tea is really famous. They are generally taken like, in the morning. A particular Indian's day will not be complete without the tea.
Exactly.
Oh, it's good.
In the evening, you eat it with snacks, you eat it before dinner, after dinner, anytime you drink something, you drink tea. So we can call it as snacks.
Most common sugar is